Good morning, students. Now we are going to discuss another topic of our chapter number 10, Traders, Kings and Pilgrims. The topic is the story of the Silk Route. The story of the Silk Route. Students, we are familiar with silk cloth. Silk clothes, they were invented in China about 7000 years ago. The characteristic of silk, the rich glossy colors of silk as well as its smooth texture, it made highly valued fabric in most societies. The characteristics of silk, that rich and glossy colors, besides that smooth texture. Due to this characteristic, silk is highly valued or highly valued fabric in most societies. Making silk, it is a complicated process. It includes raw silk has to be extracted from the cocoons of silk worms, after that spun into thread and then woven into cloth. And this making of silk, that is a complicated or complex process. It includes three stages. Raw silk has to be extracted from the cocoons of silk worms. Second, spun into thread, and third, woven into cloth. So this technique or this method of making silk, that is complicated. This technique or this method, it was first invented in China around 7000 years ago. This remember, techniques of making silk were first invented in China around 7000 years ago. This technique remained a closely guarded, means a closely protected secret for thousands of years. The craftsmen or the people of China, they kept this technique of making silk a closely protected secret for thousands of years. Later, some people went to distant land, it means to distant places except China, on their foot, horseback, or by using different means to different lands, and they carried silk with them. Some people from China, they went to distant lands and they carried silk with them. Now when they started their journey, so they followed different paths, different routes. Those routes came to be known as the Silk Route. That route came to be known as the Silk Route. Technique of making silk, it was closely protected secret for thousands of years. Later on, some people from China who went to distant land on foot, on caravans, and settled in different parts of the world. So when they followed different paths, when they followed different routes, that route came to be known as the Silk Route. The technique of making silk, it was closely protected secret for thousands of years. Later on, some people went to distant land, carried silk with them, so the knowledge was spread. Later on, that sometimes the Chinese jewelers, they sent gifts of silk to rulers in Iran and West Asia, and from that also the knowledge of silk spread further west. When Chinese rulers, sometimes they sent gifts of silk to the kings or to the rulers of Iran and West Asia, and from that also the knowledge of silk spread further. To wear silk clothes that was in fashion, especially in royal societies, as it was rich and glossy colors and a smooth texture. Due to the characteristic of silk, the royal families, they were very fond of wearing silk clothes. The silk route, it was many kings, they tried to control large portions of the silk route so that they could earn wealth in terms of taxes, gifts and tributes. And that is why many rulers tried to control large portion of the silk route. The best known or the famous rulers who controlled the silk route, they were the Kushanas. They were the Kushanas. These Kushanas, they ruled over Central Asia and Northwest India. Kushanas, they captured a large portion of the silk route. And these Kushanas, they ruled over Central Asia and Northwest India. For Kushanas, two major centers of power, they were Peshawar and Mathura. The Kushanas, they extended the Silk Route, and gradually the Silk Route extended up to Roman Empire. The Kushanas, they were the rulers, they introduced gold coins. So this is about the Silk Route, the story of Silk Route. You can see the Silk Route on our in our textbook on page number 83 or 85. Thank you, students.